Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let me show you how you could capture the screen on your Mac. So I'm using Mac OS 10.9. I'm going to show you how to take screen grabs. So a screen grab or screen capture is a way to capture an image of part of your screen, exactly what you're seeing. And you do this using keyboard shortcuts. Now to find the keyboard shortcuts for this, it's always good to know where they're kept. You go to System Preferences, go to Keyboard, go to Shortcuts, and then on the left here you actually have a category called Screenshots, and you can see the four keyboard shortcuts. Now these are things you can change, so you may have already changed them or customized them, which is why I want to show them to you here. These are the defaults. You can do Shift-Command-3, saves a picture of the entire screen as a file. And if you instead want to copy it to the clipboard, so then you could say paste it into a graphics program or into an email message for that matter without actually saving as a file, you'd simply add Control to that. So Control-Shift-Command-3. Now instead of 3, if you use 4, you're going to do a selected area. So it's the same thing. You use Control to do a clipboard, whereas without the Control, just Shift-Command-4 will save it to a file. So I've opened a Finder window here just so I have something to capture. This could be anything. It could be a Safari, you could be browsing the web, you could be looking at pictures, you could be doing anything, and you can capture it. I'm going to use Shift-Command-3 to capture the entire screen, and it's going to save a file to my desktop. It's actually going to save two files. The reason there are two files here is because I have two screens. You're only seeing the main one, and I have a secondary screen as well. So if I just double click on this one to open it up in preview, I'll see that it's the entire screen there, the main one you're seeing. This second shot is actually my second screen. So there you go. I've got a file, and I could use that to save or to send to somebody if I'm trying to troubleshoot something. I want to show them what I'm seeing. Now if I do Command-Control-Shift-3, I'll get the same sound, but no file appears. Now if I go to another app, say Pages, something that accepts images, I can Command-V, paste, and you can see it's going to paste that screenshot in there. So I was able to do that without actually having to create a file somewhere. Now let's try Command-Shift-4, and what's going to happen now is I get this little area that I can select. Just click and drag to select an area, and I'm going to get a screenshot, and the screenshot is going to just have the area that I wanted. Now I'm going to do it again. Command-Shift-4, but instead of selecting an area, I'm going to hit the space bar. And it's going to change the cursor to a little camera icon. And I can now select a window. And there's this window, or I can select the entire the desktop back here. And if I click on the window, it'll capture exactly that window. Matter of fact, it'll capture not only the window, but the area around it, which includes kind of a drop shadow. But it's not going to capture anything else, no part of the background or another window hiding behind it. I can even use that to capture menus. So for instance, here in the Finder, I can go File and say, oh, I want to capture all the items in that menu. So I'm going to do Command-Shift-4 and then Spacebar, and you can see I can highlight this menu here, and now I've got a screen capture of the menu itself. And you can see even with the drop shadow included. Now you have some more options. If you search for or just run out of your utilities folder, the grab utility, then you can do similar captures, except you have a few more options. Like for instance, you can do time to screen. So you can start the timer and you can see it count down there, and it will capture the entire screen, but you have time to actually do things, open menus and such. And when it does capture it, you can see it opens it up here in the grab utility, and you can see it didn't include that window there. So it's a good way to capture things that you can't otherwise easily capture. Now if you want to record video, you can also do that. You want to use the QuickTime Player tool. So and when you do QuickTime Player, you can start a new screen recording. I'm actually screen recording right now, which is how you're seeing this. So I can't show it to you, but the general idea is the same. You start recording, and then when you're done, instead of a file, you get a QuickTime movie opened in QuickTime Player.